One way I've integrated generative AI into my teaching is in the assessment design process, particularly for creating rubrics. I've found AI to be incredibly useful for writing detailed assessment rubrics, which are critical for marking consistency and assessment transparency, and they're immensely beneficial for student learning and self-efficacy. Using AI to help me write assessment rubrics has saved me a significant amount of course preparation time, which gives me more opportunity to thoroughly scrutinize my rubrics and have them peer reviewed before releasing them to students and markers. Having a well-designed and well-written rubric is also particularly useful if you want to limit AI use in an assessment to some extent, as you can frame the scoring strategy in such a way that the rubric emphasizes higher order thinking skills, which AI isn't particularly good at. So now I'm going to show you my method for using AI to help me write assessment rubrics. Okay, so I've logged onto Copilot, and the first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to upload the assessment brief that I've given my students. So you do that by clicking the paperclip. And that's uploading the brief now. And then I'm going to ask it, can you write me an assessment rubric for the essay attached? Please identify key criteria from the instructions. Okay, so what Copilot is doing is it's going through the assessment instructions and it's pulling out the criteria that it thinks is important for the essay. Now, I can already see that the first thing that I'm going to ask it to do is to put the rubric into a table, because it's much easier to read when it's in a table with criteria in the first column and performance levels across the top row. Okay, so I've asked it to put the rubric into a table with the criteria in the first column and performance levels across the top row. So it's doing a pretty good job. It's identified from the instructions that I've given it that I want it to identify and explain associative learning concepts, and then describe neuropharmacological processes and then integrate those processes into the associative learning concepts. It's also identifying that structure, essay structure and clarity is important, that the use of scientific literature to support claims is important, that's also good. And it's saying, yeah, that it's important to adhere to formatting and submission guidelines, which is kind of right. More APA style is what I want. Okay, so I'm just gonna check through the criteria that it's picked up. So there's two parts to this essay question. So in part one, they need to identify and explain associative learning concepts. And then in part two, they need to describe neuropharmacological processes and integrate these with the associative learning stuff. And I'm also going to have a look at essay structure. Okay. All right. So there's a few things I can see that I want to change already. So can you separate? I'm padding out exactly how I want the criteria to be broken down. So I also then want evidence and I want essay structure, grammar, style, and APA format. I'm going to see how it changes the structure of the rubric to reflect that. Okay, so you can see with this prompt, I've asked it to separate the criteria in a very specific way. I've asked it to have a criterion for part one, identify, part two, explain, part two, describe, part two, integrate, then use of evidence, essay structure, style, and grammar, and then also APA format. And so the changes that it's made are actually quite good. you can see that it's separated the criteria out exactly as I've asked it to. And it's provided performance descriptors for each level of each criterion. Okay, so that's pretty good. What I have noticed is that the scoring is not great. So we could really be improved here. See, essay structure, grammar and style is, I want to limit students' AI use to some extent and sort of emphasize things that AI can't do terribly well. One thing it is good at is structure and grammar. So what I want to do is I want to devalue that. It's still important. It needs to, an essay needs to have good structure and flow, but I want them to, something like using evidence is more important and harder for AI to do and something students need to be able to learn to do properly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to look at the weighting of each of the criterion and make some adjustments. Okay, identifying associative learning concepts, so AI is quite good at that. So I'm going to reduce that down a bit. I'm going to add a higher value to explain because it's harder for the AI to explain the concepts in enough detail and something that students need to be able to do to demonstrate that they understand a concept really well. So I'm going to make that 20%. Describe, I'm going to take down to 10% because again, the AI is quite good at explaining neuropharmacological processes, but it's not great at integrating the neuropharmacological processes with the associative learning stuff. So I'm going to bump up integrate to 20%. So there I'm on 60%. I'm going to make APA 5. And then I'm going to have essay structure style, make that 5% as well. And so then that's allowing me 30% for use of scientific evidence, which is really good because that's something the AI isn't good at and something that students need to be able to do themselves. Okay, so let's see what it does now. Okay, so that's done a pretty good job. And that's something that when we got to the peer review process and we did some cross-marking of AI-generated output, I'm fairly certain that's something that would be fairly robust in terms of AI vulnerabilities.